But whilst Naomi proceeded to withdraw her sting by the softening of her voice, it was done slowly.
Was I anything to you but comfort?
I cannot demand an explanation, Naomi, but I do think that I'm due one. Why did you engage in this conspiracy? Harry tried to keep his tone level, but the image of his house, burnt to the ground, sprang to mind. Why was my whole family to be sacrificed to see it concluded? She stood up and laid her hand on his arm, her voice gentle as she replied. That tactile gesture, and the direct gaze that accompanied her words, made him regret the implied accusation of deliberate intent. That shocked me, Harry, more than even the hanging of Bertels's crew. And believe me, I never once mentioned your name. We're alike, you and I. What I did was stirred by instinct. First Bertels with his madcap scheme, then the idea that I could revenge myself. I had no idea where it would lead, or the trouble it would cause. How many times have you set a course that you've later regretted? Harry's mind turned to the manifest, in which he listed all the details Trench needed to both suspect and locate him. That and the posters. It was an appropriate moment to remind himself that the attack on his house had not been generated by any action of Naomi Smith. What concerned him was why everyone had refused to believe him afterwards.
It seemed so simple. Set the fool up, then let Trench know who was stealing his contraband.
Through Temple? Asked Harry.
Well, that should have been enough.
But it wasn't, was it? Her hand gripped his arm tightly to emphasize her words.
You have to understand, Harry, to begin with, the name of who was backing Bertels didn't matter. I couldn't own to it myself, or they might have smoked my game.